What is up? Dude, this song's fucking crazy. It's almost over for those who don't like this type of music. Kyle, thanks for the host, man. If you guys spam the emotes, I think it pops up all over the screen as well. Like so. So the delay is pretty good, huh? Dude, that'd be awesome. All right, Hassan, Kyle, Tequila Shot, Nathan, Graffiti, thank you for the hosts. Fuse Brain, what's going on, man? How you doing? I moved some lights around. I might look a little better. We'll see. Poly count with the host, brah. Virus bra. I'm good. I think I need to take my socks off though. I'm a little warm. Although it's snowing outside, believe it. Dude, that song though, it's like, whoa, 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 whoa. Time to chill out a little bit. We'll see how this playlist goes. Just getting everything into position. Gonna be working in ZBrush vines, vinage. Get the tablet into place. Arthur, thanks for the host, man. Head trip, the host, much appreciated. Hostel, thank you. Yo, all the emotes. Oh my god. I don't think emotes show up in this screen. I could be wrong. If you try. Emote if you can. Yeah, it kind of shows up. It's like this space here. Oh shit, look at that. Look, you can see all the stuff I have. It's crazy. All right. Lurk, what's up, man? Dude, man, thanks for the host. Tuki, thank you for the host. Whoops, every time. So if you remember, we're just in the process of creating all of the vines here. Man, you guys all hosting me. It's awesome. Thanks, guys. Move this tablet into place. Dude, I really need to get a wireless connector. How are you guys doing? Welcome anyone who's it's your first time here. In the stream, we just streamed Tuesdays and Thursdays for about 3 hours, and the last hour is critiques for you guys. And yeah, just trying art. Trying art, everyone's just trying to get better, so that's what we're doing. Hey, Lack ya? I lack ya too. Audio sync? Audio sync problem? Let me. No, video looks in line with what I'm seeing, so I'm like, crab test? Crab test, anyone? Let me see. Audio test. Refresh it. Solved it. Audio's cool for you? No, audio's fine? Okay. It must be a refresh thing. Gotta love those little technical madnesses. It's crazy that we can even stream like 1080p video in like semi-real time. And there's like thousands of people doing it. Hundreds of thousands. Refresh solve confirmed. Nice. So we'll get the rest of these guys blocked out, and then we'll turn them all to mesh, and then I'll show you how I would make these tile. So we'll just do a bit of focus on some stuff here, and then we'll call it good. Deleting some points here. How you guys doing? What's what? You guys have a good like long break? I assume people had a long weekend. Guys into position. Whoa. What's a weekend? Got an eight month break thinking about working at video game industry. Don't know where though. What do you mean? You went to the beach antics? Oh my god. Was it a beach that I can imagine being nice, or was it like cold and windy? I'm gonna be religiously saving today because I don't want to deal with things. I went to Stockholm and then I got like weirdly sick like near the end, and we ended up flying back early. It was fun, let me tell you. I say weirdly sick because it was like I can always eat, and for that time I could not eat. It was super shitty. But that only lasted like 12 hours. It seemed to go away pretty fast. It's weird. Maybe it's like food poisoning or something. Hey, everybody. What's illumination McGuff? What is that? Apologies for not knowing. Reeds. Dude, the beaches here are pretty nice during that small window of warmth. Florida, land of the retired and people living in sinkholes. Florida is a really good place to go if you're a streamer. If you didn't know. Probably help you understand why there's so many streamers that live in Florida. I like the idea of this one coming up more. And then and then going back down to get under this one. Hey, what's up, Freezy? How you doing? We're just chilling here in ZBrush, getting our vines in place. I'm good, Nathan. How are you doing? Hey, what's up? Zspheres. Yeah. How you doing? How do you say your name? I was let me double check here. Zeelan? You're the stream I visited the other day, right? I could be wrong. I could be horribly wrong, and then yeah. Yeah, I posted you on my Discord as well, and I was like, hey everyone, if you need a stream to watch, go watch this one. Chill music, everything. Chill company. The majestic name, yes I do. Well, welcome to the stream. It's cool to have you here. I'm just getting some zspheres in place for some vines. It must be your first time here as well, huh? Maybe I should load up the scene so you can see what I'm up to. Why isn't that one scaling? That's weird. Oh, you just woke up? Wait, where are you at again? Was it I'm gonna be a super creeper now. Was it Chicago? I could be wrong. It's like, are you ready for super creeper mode? I keep fudging around with this specific one here. That's not true. I'm in Sweden, in southern Sweden, where the coffee's super good and super strong. Here, I'll get the, now it's important I know the people that I, send information out to the community that we have. It's important I know who you are. I did move here for work. I use it as an excuse to travel. He moved for the coffee, stayed for the work. Now the work-life balance here is freaking amazing. I'm getting those slippers on. You know the slippers, guys. Okay, I need to add two here. These ones I'll have like intertwine and like wrap around. So what I'm doing on the stream is I'm just kind of educating while I build things. I don't necessarily, I wouldn't say I'm a pro, because I mean everyone does something wrong. You know what I mean? Feet slides in. Oh shit, feels good, man. Doesn't that give you a lot of overdraw? It does, but if you look at like overdraw is the overlapping of alpha, right? So as long as I'm not overlapping a lot, then it should be fine. So what I'm building now is I'm building the high poly that will replace the blockouts of these vines. Well, this is weird doing this with a Wacom pen. But we've been, throughout the stream, we've been building all these pieces. And then we're going to build a scene from Uncharted. It's all this rubble sets and stuff like that. Yeah, so it's been a pretty slow process. I mean, I've been learning some stuff to speed things up, as well as like accepting like automated processes in a lot of cases. And then just because I'm taking a lot of your guys' questions and we're doing a lot of critiques with you guys, and I don't work on personal art outside of outside the stream, I go to work and they stream on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and then I call it good. And that's the key to not burning out, guys. Know when to chill. But Sweden actually gave me the opportunity to be able to do this as much as I am. And so I've just been in the process of slowly making the scene while helping answer questions and do critiques. Critiques are they're through the Discord. Sorry guys, for everyone who hears this like every stream. I don't have the Discord up. What is happening? Like, this is sexy, like, with a question mark. It's like, I don't know how I feel about the art I'm seeing. So we have our Discord here, and in the art related, you can post your work in progress stuff. And then on the last hour of each stream, I just start from the bottom, and then I go up and then critique everything, talk about composition, material, definition. That is hot. The mud. So I just go through and we just look at stuff and discuss the things. And then I push all of that onto my YouTube channel. And so that way it's permanently archived for you guys. Mud is always hot. This is true. But anywho, enough about that. I figured I would just introduce any people who are new here, as well as yourself. Was it Zeelan, right? Zeelan? Like spider tree action with this vine stuff here. Yeah, pixels getting rendered and but then discarded due to their transparency is always more expensive than it being rendered because it's there, right? That's of course always expensive. Not crazy expensive, it's just expensive. Where it gets crazy expensive is as you render in front of each time there's an overlap, it's gotta check that pixel however many times there's an overlap, right? I kinda wish I had Zoltan here, because he could explain it on a better technical level, I'm sure. Oh, there you go. I was like, let me delete it. Just let me get rid of that. Okay, so these are actually, when they're overlapping this close together, it's pretty easy to get some interaction between the two. Because you just duplicate it and then just start offsetting stuff. Gabe, hola, how you doing, man? Heavy stutter. How do I get a longer buffer? I have no idea. I finally get to watch and fully understand absolutely nothing. I guess, welcome to the Learn Nothing Party. It's gonna be fun. Trust me. Trust me. I'm not sure about how you get better buffer action. I think I'm gonna take this one this way. Does anyone know? Maybe I should be adjusting my stream to not... I mean, I just went with defaults here, you know? I might be doing something horribly wrong. I bet Gabe might know. Because Gabe and his masterful streaming article. So it's gonna go behind here, and then I need to grab actually this one and bring this one up. You get extremely angry about how long it takes. So the first couple environments that you do, it does take a lot of time, just because mainly you're tackling a lot of technical issues, right? I keep talking about it. I need to build this scale. There's a scale that I want to build that's like a tier system that is the easiest way to approach, like in my opinion, the easiest way to approach building environments and not like killing yourself over it. I mean, I think, so tier one is, and you guys have heard me, Abel, you're probably right. I probably need to adjust my bit rates. So the first tier is more along the lines of not worrying about getting it in game in real time and just prioritizing, recreating an asset, making sure that it looks like what it's supposed to look like. So if you're building like a trash can or a fire hydrant, dare I say, just props, a bookcase, a chest, anything. This is a little tightly wound. We're gonna soften this up a bit. But once you've mastered that, Once you can actually recreate assets, then it's time to start trying to build the low poly ones of it. So you're still not thinking about environment art, because there's a lot of technical shit that has to be hashed out in order to get nice environment art. What's up, Kyle? What's up, Volt? How you doing? Well, I mean, if you're building a scene, so once you're approaching building a scene, the first phase is blocking out a scene, right? But I'm talking about not even worrying about building a scene. Just concentrate on building assets. If you want to build a scene, I would suggest, and you're in that tier one that I'm talking about, I would suggest still building only props. That light is starting to flicker, isn't it? Are you flickering? What are you doing? Make your mind up. Are you on? No? It's flickering. If it continues to flicker, I bet I just need to do this. We'll see. I am blind right now. That is super bright. Oh, okay, you're flickering. You're done. So sorry. Now you get a moody version over here. So the two-phase lighting. Oh man, I need my eyes to adapt for a second and then I will continue on. So yeah, building a scene but still being in tier one. Hello, darkness.
Hello, old friend.
If you're in tier one that I'm talking about, I would suggest theming your props, but only concentrating on one prop at a time. That way you've got these like small bite-sized projects that you can just, you can be like, okay, I'm gonna make this prop and then it's done. And then I'm gonna make this prop and it's done. And you're gonna make this one. Cause then you get the, you know, the, it's like micro gratification of completing tasks, which feels nice and promotes you to continue that process. It's like micro, it's like what mobile games do, like micro loops in AAA title games or things that don't take very long to do that reward you. Feels good. Gets that dopamine hit. Yeah, so you just finish the prop and then you're good, right? But when it comes to that, you might just be having a lot of temp props and a temp scene. Yeah, because it turns into a bunch of stuff. Turns into a lot of stuff. But if you have all those props, then you can, if they're themed in the same fashion, then you can move forward with eventually building a scene. What's up, Blue? How you doing? Yeah, see, and that when you're at work, that's a good process mainly because it guarantees that work doesn't get too far before everyone, like your art director or production, gets to see it and make sure that everything's heading in the right direction. Without that process, that stuff can get too far ahead, and then if it ends up being cut, that's really shitty. What? There we go. And you can work like that at home. The other really big thing is just deadlines. Just give yourself deadlines and you'll be in a much better spot. That's fine. I kind of want it to continue. And it does. It's down here. So let's put it through. Tier two would be making low polys and then baking and getting the perfect bakes. So you're not even texturing yet. You're not worrying about PBR. You're not thinking about like roughness values and making sure that everything looks right. And you're just concentrating on getting the perfect normal matte bakes and like the silhouette of your asset looking fine and not looking low poly, even though it is. If I were a teacher, I think that's how I would teach. So I wouldn't let a student graduate to texturing and substance until they can actually model something and make it look the same from the high poly to the low poly with the normal matte bake. You're getting too far ahead of yourself with texturing, even though texturing is awesome and fun, which is why we end up going so far ahead. Cause like I'm trying to promote you understanding the entire process. Right, we're gonna open some books now. Oh, interesting. So you want to make one prop that's going to take a long time. What's up, Bedlam? How you doing? Bedlam. Belfryo? Is that how you say that? I am blocking out some vines in with some zspheres right now. Once we get to a... Wow, this song is crazy. We're going to go to a more chill playlist. feel like all my music's been getting just a little bit more intense. What about this one? Yeah, I'll be making an alpha out of it, and hopefully we'll be doing some... I plan to have some palms, some parallax offset mapping on this stuff too, because in the long run, it's just going to be baked down to like this. So it'll replace these textures, and then we can get that depth, and then I'm like, this music is not, I'm not, not feeling it, guys. Not feeling it. Yeah, so I'll make a curvature height map, probably some color map so I can separate the small vines from the larger vines. Plays death metal. Winter blanket maybe has some chill. Actually, you know what I could do is just go to the chill playlist. This one. There we go. Plays a SpongeBob song? I don't know about that, man. Love me some SpongeBob, though. Yeah, so this playlist, they have a Spotify playlist that they build off of. Zeeland, actually, I believe that's what she was playing on her. That playlist is really good. Okay, I need to move faster. We're like not blasting through this stuff at all. Just give me the vine. Can I just have the vine? There we go. So can I have the other one? Is that cool? Yes, I can. That'll get your heart pumping. I don't know if I want to put you guys through that. Over the top. Let's go over the top. Let's get some more interaction going on with these vines. Yeah, that happens. If you listen to this stuff long enough, it turns into electro anime madness, which I mean, it's fine. You just gotta be in the mood for it. If you're not in the mood for it, it's not fine at all. This is not okay. I don't like this. This vine's getting all types of twerky. So calm down, vine. Calm down. It's going to be cool. It's fine. This is fine. Yeah, the stuff you're talking about, though, is pretty difficult dealing with burnout, because like passion drives you, right? And then you're just like, passion will drive you into madness, and then you're tired. Yeah, it was one of the reasons I was drawn to your channel. It's very similar to mine. It's very, it's just about hanging out and learning and working on stuff and chatting with, engaging with chat. I think I'm just going to continue this one down here, but I'm going to hide it behind as if they're two separate ones. That's a good idea, right? Yeah. This is also a pretty tedious way to do this. I mean, you could get a very similar effect in Maya or Max pretty easily. It's okay though, I like this. It gives me time in ZBrush, which is fine. You're drooling over my portfolio. It's drool. It's all over the place. Oh my god. Thank you. I don't post like nearly enough stuff. It took me forever to put the division stuff on there. Yeah, you got to learn how to ration your passion. See what I did there? Oh man. The song calls for coffee. It's funny, as I was drinking a beer and having tacos, and then I was like, all right, time to stream, and now I'm drinking coffee. My body's like, what the fuck are you doing, man? What are you doing? The pun. Tacos, please. What do you mean? What do you mean, please? Like, you want some, or you're like, what a pleb? How dare you attack my tacos? They're good, man. They were avocado, garlic, mushroom, with mango, like a mango chutney on the top. No. Some salad in there. Oh, God. I would never. How dare you? I like to make these vines wiggle a little bit because they tend to do weird, like. It's like the most hipster taco you've ever heard. Well, I mean, it's just dressing that sounds fancy as fuck, but it's not. No tacos in your place? Oh, man. I need to, maybe sometime when I'm in a better position, I can stream some, like, let's make some developer food. That'll go well, I think. I don't know. Have to turn this into a food channel for that day, which is kind of weird. But whatever it takes, right? Whatever it takes. This song is great. C- cooking with Dynasty, baking with Dynasty, all the goods. Uh-oh. Do you guys know what this means? I've seen it happen a couple times. It's when you like, let me see if I can switch to this one. It's when you, I can't even fake the, what happens. That, I'm like deleting the strip, but the strip is still connected? I don't know. See, it's like what's happening here? It's the same hotkey work for when you like, when you hit Alt, when you're in Edit and Draw, and then you click on a sphere, it goes away, right? But if you do it on an edge, it gets rid of the edge. Some scary shit, man. I don't know what's going on there. Yeah, it's really weird, right? No idea. We are almost done here. This top left one's gonna be a little on the crazy. What does it look like with A? What do you mean? What's up, Lewis? How you doing? Bob man, how you doing, Mr. Bob? Are you talking about if I like preview? So if I let's do this. Okay, I hide that. And then I go down here. We preview. It's still connecting it. Oh, I forgot that you, thanks. I forgot that you can just do that. Tap A and you'll preview your mesh. You're the dopeness. So you guys see that? Instead of having to go all the way down here to adaptive skin, you can just, yeah, you can just press A. So I can just do that stuff, see what these all look like. Man, look at that topo. Good stuff. You didn't even know there was a menu? Oh, that's great. Yeah, I think that menu is pretty old school. I think that's like ZBrush 2.5 or ZBrush 3 is when they had that. What's up, pros? Or pro-yos? I'm too advanced? Nah, just old. I'm just old. You know if there's a way to mass delete? If I just like, instead of having to tap on each one of these guys, like is there a faster way? There's gotta be, because that would make no sense if there wasn't. Grow a beard? Dude, that's actually physically impossible. It's, we can't do that. When you're making dusty metal, should you make the dusty areas metallic as well? No, those should be not metallic. Nate, what's going on? Master Flash. How's it going, dude? I'm preparing all of this stuff for Vine action. So we're just we're positioning all this stuff, and then when we're done with it and we think it looks fine, we can turn these into geometry like so, and then we'll sculpt away, and then we'll make a tile and all that jazz. You just gotta believe, man. Oh, I'd hate to grow a bread. Actually, growing bread sounds amazing. Unless it was growing on my face, then I don't know. Something would be greatly something's wrong. If there's bread growing off my face, I wouldn't be streaming. I'd probably be seeing a professional about the best approach to handle a beard growing from the face. I love it. That sounds so weird. Be Treebeard from Lord of the Rings. Could sell that shit. Someone would buy it, dude, for sure. To be like, this is super rare beard bread, Dynasty beard bread. That's for sure. If I ever get a sub button, that's gonna be an emote, beard bread. I should probably talk to Twitch about that again. There's 52 of you in here. Just chilling. Listen to me talk about beard bread while I move spheres around that are attached together. You guys are awesome. It's like, it's fine. This is fine. No, let me do what I want. That's what I want to do right there, like that. Dude, so many hotkeys with this thing, it's crazy. We don't even need this many points. As I try and add more. You know what I should do is probably add a plane in the background. Oh, what is Epic doing? What are they talking about? Dude, that's weird. They have the same time window as me. I'm going to have to talk to him about that. This always wins? Is that because, notice me, senpai? Dude, if Epic was like, hey, Punk, how's it going? Punky, how you doing? We'd be like, oh my god. We'd all start crying. Involuntary crying. Like, oh god. It's true. They know. Are you going to bake this texture inside of ZBrush? I will probably take the height map from this and bring it into Substance Designer and build from there, actually, for most of it. You guys will be, I won't do that off stream, so you guys can see how I'm thinking about stuff. It's more of like this is me experimenting with a process that I've been wanting to try. So I'm basically doing this to get a nice height map, and I'll have like a source mesh that I can go back to, mainly because I'll want to possibly arrange them around or get rid of some of them to adjust how many are there and all that stuff. Does that answer your question? So Epic flesh out new info, but you emit an incomparable amount of conciseness. Am I reading that right? Conciseness? Most of the time I feel like I'm rambling. Like old man rambles action going on. And coziness. Oh, I see. There's no N in there. I'm like, conciseness. I wish. My God, I wish. All right, Nathan, enjoy your whatever you're eating. Bet it's not tacos. So I am rambling. Oh, I knew it. Fucking knew it. This song just feels good. Know what I'm saying? Insightful ramblings. All right. Saved it. Ruined. Saved. So we're going to shrink some of this down. Whoa, hello. This is way more work than it needed to be. And I have to scale it too. Jesus. Jesus. Oh man, it's starting to get warm in this room again. The summer is going to be rough, especially with the padding that we have in here now. It's going to get real, guys. I have like a tank top on. You guys are like, whoa, man, where's he live at? You're like, actually, it's freezing outside. But it's heated up in here. Okay, this should do it. And then we'll take this guy. Take this guy. Please let me have F. Is it snowing? It was snowing earlier. Next donation goal, ceiling fan. That sounds nice. There we go. Okay, so active points make it very difficult to shift these around. Active points when it's red. Fear, that's amazing. How you doing, dude? I didn't get a chance to see you at work today. That's hilarious. The only thing that bugs me about these vines right now. You miss the people on the fifth floor? Soon, man, soon. I thought you liked the quiet. So the things that are bugging me right now is, so you've got, we'll ignore this part right here, right? We've got this shape. And then we have a very, it's close. There's a very similar shape here and then a negative space here. Oh, what am I drawing, guys? Oh my god. It's kind of getting broken up, but there's, you see the problem I'm that's bugging me? It's like there's the same space. Oh, you guys probably aren't going to be able to unsee this now. Was that a uterus? No, man. No. Do you see the problem now? That's gonna bug me. As long as we don't use the texture tiling as a whole and we use it in parts, I think we'll be okay. But a problem like that will basically make the texture not as awesome. People, no, I will not repeat that work for you. Are you experiencing a no delay stream? Interesting. You're like, the fuck is this? 2-3 more vines to go, guys. Sorry, this is taking a little longer than I was expecting. I like this. I think I like this process, though. We'll see. We'll see how it turns out. Call it the caterpillar workflow because it's slow and there's caterpillars. We're making vines out of caterpillars. ¿16-second delay for you, Blue? Oh my god, I'm sorry. This is going to be, this spot's going to be difficult, I think, to solve with the tiling. We'll figure it out. Delay test. Fear, you're probably pretty quick, considering you're not very far away from me. I like this. Getting some more overlap. Overlap's good for this type of stuff because you're going to end up seeing a lot more of the interactions between them and how they shift. Awesome. Yeah, see, this corner's gotten really interesting because of that. This one, however, is going to need to be brought back just so I can solve it in the tile easier. There we go. Later, Kyle. Yeah, I've already checked that guy. Oh, what am I doing? Just put this guy back here. Have this one do that. So one of the things I'm anticipating I'm going to have a problem with is the fact that I'm going to need to turn all of these into mesh. There's not a like do it to all subtools button as far as I know. Also, we'll be looking at your guys' stuff in maybe about 50 minutes or so. So if you want to get some stuff critiqued, just post it. Post it in the Discord under the art-related thread. We'll help you out as best as possible. Let's see what happens. Okay, so now that I've saved, let's just do that and see what happens. Yeah, no. Nope. That's not gonna, okay. Okay, so as long as we've saved this, so let's start trying to do some stuff. There's no merging, as you can see. This music is feeling good. It's actually, I'll show you guys what I'm thinking about doing. So, if we make a new document that's at, let's do 4096. Oops. By 4096. Oops. No. Oh, that's cool. Nope. Zoom out on this. So what we're doing here is we're zooming in and out on the canvas itself. So it's just taking up less pixel space. Then we can drag out these guys. Right? And if I set them up like that, we go into here, go to subtools, we go to the texture that we have here. Let's remove the alpha, so it's just a square. We turn the, make sure the perspective is off. And then we press F, we'll frame the texture, right? So the texture framed, then I turn everything back on. Go to one of them, turn the texture off. And then you can do a grab dock from here. So now you can see I've got my alpha. So if I grab this, I can let's export that as a test every time. And then we'll go into Photoshop. I think you can actually do this in ZBrush now, but I can't remember. Let's open. No, we don't want to do that. So here's our vines, right? Then we could do an offset, and we'll do 2048 by 2048. You can see there's some slight mismatches happening and like scale issues, like maybe this one's off scale and all that stuff. These things we will just fix in ZBrush. They're going to be a bit of a hassle, but we'll solve them. They're not that big a deal. So you would save this, and then you come back in here. Let's make a new plane, alpha, import, zgrab. There's a new offset texture. And I'm trying to remember how you do this. Masking. mask by color. Hang on here. Gotta make this a poly mesh. Oh, we gotta do by the alpha, mask by alpha. So you can see, super low res, guys. Subtool, geometry, let's go higher res. Divide. Tobias, that's fine. Where was I at? Masking. Mask by alpha. So you have this, right? And then you can do deformation. I'm all doing this in my head, just so we all know. Who knows if this is going to work or not? Actually, we don't even have to do that. We can just do this. So we're going to need a higher res mesh, of course. But then we just clean that up. And as long as we're sculpting with the tiling on, we can get a pretty good tiling base down, and we can sculpt on this, and we just tile the brush. Wonder why it's so pixelated. That's really interesting. So I go to the lowest, we'll delete higher. We'll divide without, wait a tick. Go here, delete higher. Huh. There we go. Okay, that's low res. It smoothed out your edges. So just hit divide without the smoothing on. There we go. And then let's see what resolution we got going on here. Oh. The depth 16. That's shit. Just run some tests here. Yeah, so wow, we're seeing all of the gradient information from the actual mesh. That's hilarious. This is good though. Okay, cool. Cool. Okay, so knowing that, I'm just gonna keep moving. So we need to get this guy. And I need a new document that's not this big. See how much smoother this is? What's up, Casual? We were just looking at the alpha that I'm the height map that I'm going to extract to tile these vines after the fact. The shitty part is I think because of the way that I've constructed these, because they're all separate, I actually need to process each one individually, which is kind of shitty. So we'll do a handful of them so you guys can just watch me sculpt for a little while. And then, yeah. Basically what we want to do is this. So if we We can do that and then sculpt on those. That would be perfect. And what happens if I... So I'm on this one. Let's go to this one. So I'm on this one. If I duplicate that... Okay, it's still interesting. It's still Z-spheres, so... Can turn the density up too. Ooh. We'll go to 3. This is what I'm talking about though. This is kind of shitty, this process. Because now what I would need to do is then go up to one of these. Let's say this one, for example. And then append. And then append all of those. Actually, it didn't take too long, but kind of annoying when you think about it. And then we just go in and start going to town on these. Start sculpting them and changing their shapes and whatnot. We need to make sure to keep this one, though, so that we can frame everything nicely with the background stencil that we'd used to map all these out. But yeah. So let's get some reference up and we'll start sculpting on this stuff. Oh yeah, I'm gonna close this. So for anyone that's new here, this is some of the set that we're working on for the temple scene. We've got these ceiling pieces that we recently did, or like the roof trim pieces. We've got this guy. This vine stuff was the block out for what is now being worked on. So the idea is once we get all this stuff looking really good, we'll output a good height map and we'll build the rest in Substance Designer and then get that looking nice in here. And then we should just be able to replace the texture and then the vine should all update accordingly. Should be good. And then we've got all these pieces as well, these like rubble ground pieces. So we're just building a set to build a scene. And yeah, and if this is your first time here, you can go to the YouTube. You can go to the YouTube link and all of this stuff is archived. And there's timestamps in each of the videos in the descriptions and stuff. The trials and tribulations of the Empire is, I guess, what we would call it. But yeah, all right, I'm gonna close this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, 2, 4. Yeah, 6. So there's only 5 in this one. So we're missing one. We are missing this one. Z-sphere 1, 4. Go here, append. Z-sphere 1, 4. I'm like, dude, which one is that? See, this is where it's going to become a problem. 1, 2, 3. F. You see what the problem is? Is this way overcomplicated to do this? So the reason we're doing it this way is so that I can actually sculpt the vines. I mean, I could sculpt to a tileable, but I want the control in order to go back and make other vine layouts using this file. So in the grand scheme, if I was making just one tileable, way overcomplicated. But if I want to make a ton of stuff, are you serious, Bedlam? That's terrifying. I might not need that update. I don't think you can avoid it though. But yeah, so in the grander scheme of things, if this is like a big process, it needs to have a good reason for doing something this complicated, right? And the main reason is so that I can make iterations on vine placement, different versions. Now that I have all of these in place, I can just like isolate certain ones and make a completely different tileable. I can change the arrangements of them as well. So that's the end goal. So this is more of like the back end technical bullshit that you that I have to deal with. But yeah, it's a bit tedious for sure. Dude, this song is crazy sounding. I need to delete this. In general, Windows 10 I'm actually really happy with, though. Just so we know. Dude, I wish I could just grab this and drag it on here. That'd be cool. Looks like it's that one. Skin Zsphere 1. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. These two are the same. Paint 3D. Sarcasm, can you taste it? So once I construct this setup, I'm gonna save it out so I don't have all these subtools, because this is this will get messy really fast. So this guy, we're just gonna grab him again. What's up, Raz? How you doing? Casual, does that make sense, though? Why I'm making it as complicated as it is? Because it is definitely a bit overcomplicated. Okay, so we're going to save as top right instead of project. Set 1. And then we will document... new document, no, or actually, project. This is so weird. Do you guys know how to clear a project without, dude, there's whistling happening. Tool mesh, spotlight. Interesting. All right, we're gonna. Oh, I'm gonna do this. So, Control N will create a new canvas. You're trying to understand? All right. So, Control N will make a new canvas, but it will not clear your tools palette, which is why you would want to save a tool out individually. So I can Control N, now I have this, right? And it has none of the guys in here. Gonna get the reference stuff out here. You're not a pro at 3D. So what is your what's your story, man? How you doing? Tell me about yourself. You made a goblin head? Dude, awesome. You could always download Sculptress. Look at this guy. For our inspiration. Dude, look at these vines. They're like melted together. How crazy. That's interesting. This is interesting too. Makes me wonder if these two should melt together. Going to append a plane as well, just so that we have, so we understand where the edge is. The kink looks really strange. All right, let's do this. Keep this pretty low for now. Oops, sorry. Probably bumped the mic and made it super loud. Just make stone out of it, guys? Yeah? Cool. Holy casual. ZBrush Core, ZBrush or Substance Painter, and 3S. Oh, and Maya. Okay. Nice vault. You're like, what the hell? This is weird. It's in the layer tab. Okay, so layer and clear. That just clears this stuff, right? Interesting. I'll try that here. 'Cause like in here, like you can't auto hide 2D tools. What? Oh my god. How did I never know about that button? That's awesome. I don't need to see the 2D tools. So something we should look at is brushes. Over here and then curve. There's wrap mode. So wrap mode 1 just tiles once. So if I go here and start I probably can't sculpt on this because it's not a mesh. So I need to delete this, append to the mesh. That wrap mode's for each individual brush as well. You see how I switch brushes and it goes away? So if I go back here, you can see the wrap mode is there. Wrap mode one. So let's go to like cracks, for example. We'll need to divide this as well so you can see. Okay, so no wrap on. If you turn wrap mode on, just continues over. And as far as I know, it does a pretty good job of maintaining the tile. You want to keep your perspective off as well when you're sculpting, and don't work on the edge directly, just because you're going to get some discrepancy in the height. What's up, Beard? How you doing? How's it going, man? Anyways, let's start trying to think what I should use to start building this all out. So another thing that we'll probably want to do is try to get rid of all of this edging that's happening in here. And you can just do deformation and you can polish it a little bit. It should smooth everything out in general. And then we need to get our reference up, and then we need to always on top that stuff. Mainly I'm doing this to start getting the creases in it that are so common throughout the shape. And remember, I don't know what I'm doing. Last stuff for portfolio launch. Oh my God, man. You're welcome to post it in chat if you'd like. People can check it out and see where people from the game assembly are landing as far as the quality based on like your current understanding of stuff and all that. Wonder if I can, if I take this, move this over here, if I take this and start using a round alpha, that kind of works. I can fake some vines. Interesting. I'm still debating if I should melt these together. It's kind of interesting. And I think I want to move this forward. Yeah. Move that forward. Move this one a little forward. Pinion, what's up, man? Yeah, we're getting these set up. I took the long road. Z-Sketch. How you doing, dude? Let's shrink this down. We don't need it too big. Trim dynamic will allow me to get push some of the weird rounding down as well when I need to. If I inverted as well. I can get some that type of stuff going on, and then bring this back over. Wooby, what's going on, man? Tired? Why are you always tired, dude? What's going on? Working too hard? Don't work too hard. Okay, man. So right now what I'm doing is just kind of looking for shapes that I can play around with. And when these overlap, it gives you a really good opportunity to have like that where vines kind of overgrow over each other and they cause a bit of tension, which is kind of like what fabric would do if it was resting on stuff. So it gives you the perfect opportunity. See, later I can do things like add this crack brush to emphasize those a bit. Can do things like that. And then indents where I need it. Then you can, we want to trim smooth. We can then like round those edges out when we need to. Anywho, yeah. So we're gonna get there. It's basically the look we're starting to go for here. It's alive. And you can use this the crack brush as well to help define some shapes as well. As well as well, as well, as well as well as well. Like, I don't like that. You guys are getting an idea for kind of how I'm approaching this. So, do you guys have any questions about anything? Take those too. See if we can find a good area for a knot or something. I'm like, oh, what have I done? There we go. There's not really any knots in this. Oh. Hey there. Hello. Hello, everyone. It's pretty straightforward rootage, root vinage. Probably Probably could actually smooth this out, but then like merge this one into this one. Why is furniture so heavy? It's by design. They made it heavy to be annoying. So I can like build this up. Just do that for now. Yubba dubba dubba doo. So what we'll do there is we'll actually DynaMesh these together at some point. Casual, you're all types of questions right now, man. I mean, it's kind of like this stuff. Like, this is all vine trunkage. Like, this long stringy stuff, I'm probably going to have to build, like, a nice, like, basic... probably build those in Substance Designer. This stuff is probably what I'm more interested in. But, yeah, I mean, sure. So you're gonna join the Discord and start trying to build some stuff? I'd love to watch you grow as an artist. Be super cool. Well, you've been watching the YouTube channel? Awesome. I'm glad you're liking it. The original goal of that... There's a girl on... What? My sister just messaged me. She's like, there's a girl in my class that graduated with you. I'm like, dude, crazy. Education's a crazy thing, man. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, that YouTube channel was originally made just to support people that were watching the stream but had missed it and needed, like, some archive footage. And the YouTube channel guaranteed that the archive would never go away. And actually, there's a lot of people that watch the YouTube channel, which is kind of cool. God damn, this song is chill. I got my sound padding. Yeah, dude. All thanks to you guys. It's much appreciated. The next goal is to get a boom mic so my mic isn't sitting here. And I just have it on an arm that comes in. That way my arms aren't, like, navigating around this object in front of me. And then the other thing is, what is that? It says on the stream, bottom left. A laptop stand. So I'll have, like, the third screen on the left here. I should get my laptop on Thursday. And then on that screen, I'll have the Discord up at all times so I can kind of, like, scroll and see what's happening. That way I can keep my other monitor for the stream stuff that's live at the time. For now, we'll just do this and say that those are merged together, and we'll merge those later. Don't want to necessarily dynamesh them together yet. Steven, what's up, man? Steven Verix. Please report to the principal's office. Busted. PewDiePie ripoff? Oh man, I have no idea. I watch that guy on occasion. I haven't watched him in a while, actually. But I used to spectate the Pewds. You're back, what'd you miss? Vinage. This is a little too emphasized, I think. Let's do that. Smooth that out. So we're just working our way down these vines. I really like this more narrow one here. But yeah. So what I'm trying to do is just block out some of the more interaction shapes and using this crack brush to help define to find some shapes, positive and negative. It's a magical thing. Oh yeah, and Nathan, here, I'll repeat this, everyone. You're like, I didn't want anyone to see this. But Nathan donated some money, and now we're gonna get a new webcam. Getting fancy. Lack of motivation? Yeah, inspiration is the cure. Whoops. I notice that I lack motivation when I don't have something to solve. I've learned that I like to problem solve more than actually complete art, which is kind of annoying. So by streaming, I've kind of solved that for myself. I'm always trying to solve something or help you guys solve something, which leads to me just continuously working on the same scene while I solve stuff. And discipline and deadlines, you can be motivated, but you can only be motivated for so long. My good buddy, Matthew O'Halloran, that guy put deadlines on himself, and that's, so he's a good artist already. He was a good artist then as well, but when he put deadlines on himself, he instantly exploded quality-wise, because then he just had to, like, he only had so much time, right? So he was kicking out work really quickly, and he's already pretty disciplined in regards to, like, learning from mistakes or learning from just experience of as he's building stuff. So because of the deadlines and the speed at which he was building things, he just got better faster as well. And yeah, it's really interesting to watch. So if you can solve that part, then you're in a pretty good spot. Right now I'm kind of confused as to what I'm going to do with this bottom area here. I think I'll do something like that. No, we don't want the. I keep grabbing that chip brush. So flow wise. Thickness here is pretty nice, and then it gets wide again here, so that's kind of probably just start moving this in a bit. That'll probably help with selling the And this song almost has some Christmas vibes to it. It's weirding me out. Bottom eyes, what's up, man? Let's see, this part is now bridging between here and here. Just spreading a word. Nice. I'm good. I'm good, dude. Just working on some art and showing things and answering questions. Nice. Oh, Bob, I wish there was an empire emoji. That would be awesome. Check it. This bottom piece feels really confused. Oh yeah, when you say I go black, I'm pressing V, which switches the colors here. So if you ever have that happen, you just press V again and we can imagine it. Nice. Just press V again and it'll switch back to the alternate color. If you don't want that to happen, you just do color and then fill object, and the objects that you have selected will be filled with white. So if you press V, you see those ones don't switch because they're already filled with the color. You just do this. Press V. Now we can use it to mask out the background when we need to. Oh, we missed this one. Favorite software for architectural modeling was 3ds Max for a very long time. Now that I'm in Modo, I really like it. I like the Modos. One of the things that's really nice about Modo for architectural modeling. Lego designer, yeah. Is that in Modo you can actually type in that you want the length of a mesh or a wall. Let's say you're like, I want the wall to be like five feet. You type in 5 feet and it will just convert it to meters for you. So they just kind of accept the fact that Imperial still kind of exists. And by still kind of, I mean it exists. It's just weird. Imperial's weird. But yeah, dude, it's awesome because you can actually type in like 3 feet 3 feet and I don't know 17 inches, and it will just figure it out. It's awesome. Opinion. Don't make me take your sword away, man. You know who complains about red wax? Old people. Old people opinion. Old people. Dude, all these are bugging me too. I need to download like a better one. This one's a little on the bright side, but it's cool. It's cool. No, you're cool now? No. No, man. You'll never be cool after that Wacom under the desk incident. Never.
Yeah, I'm old too, dude. It's okay. You getting the gray hairs yet, man?
All right, it's 9:11. Visceral, thanks for the host, dude. Not PC, I didn't even catch you, man. Thanks for the host. And Seer. Seer Hika. Thank you for the follow. Bofrio. Lobotomized, man. This guy, I like you. You're like easily triggered. Dude, so the time 9/11 actually pops up for me quite often prior to streaming. It's crazy. I don't know what the heck or why or what. But yeah. You know what I need to do? I need to duplicate this because I feel like one day I'm going to accidentally save over this and then all that shit's gone. Okay, so let's go ahead. We're going to switch to your guys' stuff. At heart. I love it. You're like, oh. nice. We love this. Okay. Let's close this guy. So if you go to the Discord and post in the art-related thread down below, I will be critiquing your guys' work, starting from the bottom up. And I will be doing that until 10 o'clock, so for about 45 minutes. If you post anything in there after I get started, I will be getting to your stuff last. If I end up not getting to it, it's because I hardly got through the list above. So. And it looks like there's not too much going on, so there's a chance. Luminati confirmed. My God. All right, I will be right back, and then we will do some critique action. Enjoy the music while I get these images ready.